Tonight, the Care 11 investigative team is launching a new series exposing how our state is failing to care for those battling mental illness and, as a result, putting the public at risk. And it's the result of months of work by these two reporters, AJ Legault and Brandon Stahl, here with Care 11. Thanks for taking the time and taking a few minutes at least to talk about this series with us. And I want to start by just talking about the title here, The Gap. What is The Gap?
Let's say you're charged with a crime, and in order to be able to stand trial for that crime, you need to be able to assist with your attorney, assist with the defense. But when you're found unable to do that, you were found to be incompetent to stand trial. Well, that's the first part. So what happens to that person after they are found incompetent to stand trial? Are they given the treatment that they need and the supervision that they need in a way that not only helps them but protects the public? And what we found is that often is not happening, that they're falling into this gap that we've identified.
People falling through the cracks, so to speak. And there was a very big reason why this investigation was prompted, correct?
Correct. This investigation started with what happened at the Allina Clinic in Buffalo earlier this year, when someone went in and opened fire and began throwing pipe bombs. And we had a lot of unanswered questions as we started looking into the case. And one of the big ones was, how did this man, who we found had a history of mental illness, who'd been found to be incompetent in a prior criminal case, how did he legally go out and buy a handgun?
You've explored that topic with the victims of the Buffalo shooting, with some high-profile lawmakers, but you also engaged the man at the center of this himself. Can you talk about that, AJ?
Yeah, we did speak with the accused Buffalo gunman, and I just want to say what we're not going to do is give this man a platform to, you know, spout conspiracies, to give justifications for what he did. But there are some really big questions that only he could answer, including, where did he get a gun? We found out he just walked into a Fleet Farm and purchased that handgun. No red flags, no issues raised at all, even though he'd been found mentally incompetent to go to trial in a prior criminal charge.
When those charges were dropped, were you provided any mental health care?
No.
Now again, that's what spurred all of this investigation, but that's not all you found. How prevalent is this gap that you were investigating over so many months?
Well, we found thousands of cases that were like Ulrich, where this person was found incompetent to stand trial, but they were not ordered to get mental health treatment. We found that in misdemeanor cases, like Ulrich's, those cases are just dismissed out of hand. Under Minnesota law, wow, That's what is supposed to happen. That's the requirement. With felonies and gross misdemeanors, cases that were more serious than the one Ulrich initially faced, we're finding that half the time, they're not ordered to get mental health treatment.
And that did, in some cases, result in some serious crimes and threats to the public?
Absolutely, very much so. We found assaults, robberies, burglaries. We found sexual assaults as a result of these cases.
Wow. Judges' hands are really tied. At the end of the day, we found judges saying, there's nothing we can do. Our hands are tied in these cases.
So many times, reporting like yours has prompted changes on that front. It's obviously, the public hasn't seen this reporting yet, but do you know of any action being taken so far that might be promising for Minnesotans?
I'll let you feel that one, Brandon.
So, yes, we did present our findings to Senator Jim Abler, who is the head of the Senate Human Services and Reform Committee, and he immediately said, look, we need to address this. We need to call for a hearing. We need to make sure that this is something that Minnesota needs, that gets fixed. That first hearing will be held tomorrow at 10 o'clock.
All right, thank you so much for your reporting, Brandon and AJ. Their stories and their series kicks off tonight at 10 o'clock on Care 11.